This isn't the Bureau's first time in Bright Falls. 1970, 76, 8. Last one was in 2010. It's not exactly clockwork, but this town sees way more altered world events than most. We knew it was just a matter of time before the lake acted up again. After the AWE in 2010, the FBC's research department set up a facility, the Lake House, to study the threshold in Cauldron Lake, find better ways to contain the entity inside. Your tax dollars at work. When we detected a spike in paranormal activity at Cauldron Lake, before I even knew you were on this case, Saga, the Lake House was my first stop. I was shorthanded, hoped they could spare some help, maybe give us some intel on the situation. If I had any clue what was waiting for us in there, Saga, I just kept on driving. This is Agent Kiran Estevez responding to an AWE alert in the vicinity. I need to speak with the Marmonts. So much for the welcome wagon. You all set up the perimeter. We're on the threshold's doorstep, so keep your eyes peeled.
Yes, ma'am.
This shouldn't take long, okay? You see anything, radio me.
Roger that.
Agent Kiran Estevez, requesting entry.
I don't have time for this.
The Lake House was run by the research department. Research and investigations don't really see eye to eye. What they call science, I call a violation of Bureau protocol and human decency. Classic interdepartmental drama, your FBI saga, you know how it goes. Now, in retrospect, my low opinion of the research department may have clouded my judgment. Hello? Agent Kiran Estevez, Investigations Department. No one wants to check the individual carrying a firearm into a restricted government facility? No?
As I'm sure you know, I am Dr. Jules Marmont, and this is
an experiment. That bodes well. Locked. Dr. Marmont's not here. Nobody is? I'll have to check downstairs. Changing passwords, huh? They must all be working on the lower levels. I'll need to head down. This should come in handy.
Thank you.
as I got in that elevator, my bad news detector started going nuts. Estevez to team, something's going on in the lake house. I want all nearby agents to... Oh, shit! Come on. Threshold event had hit the lake house. Now, it was the Marmont's problem. Our mission was outside. Where's the fucking elevator? Okay. Priority one, get the lights on. Standing around in the dark near Cauldron Lake is not smart. Dr. Darling. Okay, he doesn't do a damn thing without power. Power core receiver. Plugging a core in should get the lights on. Need a higher clearance keycard. That is not a regulation FBC weapon. Jill's keycard could be useful. Wish they'd make these things lighter! The way I saw it, there was only one way out. Identify the source of the event and contain or eliminate it. Now, good news, I just had to keep going down. Bad news, the elevator liked to disappear. Can't open it from the side. At least the elevator's back. working. You never really get used to the shit you see in this job, but you can learn techniques to adjust, to function. Take 6 deep breaths. Then work. Find the source, collapse the threshold. Entity are you? You can speak. That means you probably imprinted on a person or retained some of your former self's information. Previously human, maybe? Okay, I can work with that. I just had an unpleasant encounter with some other painted individuals. Any relation?
A thousand paintings use crude.
What does that mean?
Paint no brush, a self-portrait!
Okay, hey, calm down!
Firing his eyes and hands and bones!
Bad news? That thing is really pissed off. Good news. It didn't try to kill me. Okay, baby steps. Angry living paintings are not typically on the Cauldron Lake bingo card. Something different was happening at the lake house, and I couldn't let it escape. Bright Falls didn't need this particular cherry on its already shitty sundae.
Sublevel 3.
September 12th, 2023. Notes regarding a page of an Alan Wake manuscript I found in the archives. I checked the records, and this page is not in our inventory. I believe it manifested inside the lake house directly. I won't be filing this page. It'll just send Jules into a panic. The page is written in Wake's usual style, so I can't say for certain if it's being literal or figurative when it calls us monsters. But what's interesting is that the page indicates that a painting succeeded in linking Cauldron Lake's threshold with our facility. Writing has always been the clearly superior avenue of research, but I never considered that the writing itself would dictate a different art form as the catalyst for our success. I cannot accept that. I can't allow Jules to stumble his way into success. Not after the years of work I put into this research. Yesterday, the two riders are visiting White Falls. I will beat Jules to the finish line.
Diana and Jules Marmont had once been a team. Rising stars in the Bureau, both talented in their own way. Diana innovated and Jules got funding from the bureaucrats. Cooperation led to respect. Connection. Then after a decade of hard work, the happy couple were promoted. Co-heads of research. Their first years at the lake house were good. Challenging, but not insurmountable. Not for them. Rudolph Lane stood back from the canvas. He didn't recognize the piece. Did he paint this? His mind was foggy, unfocused. He knew the Marmots were putting something in his food. A man in a white coat came to steer Lane back to his cell. He did not resist. He was too tired. He lay on the bed. But the stench in his cell wouldn't let him sleep. An acid stink. The turpentine. The paint. It was all over him. Years of it. 1,000 paintings, 1,000 more to come, a putrid weight he could never wash away.
Please don't let this be what I think it is. As you know by now, typewriters and Cauldron Lake do not mix. And a room full of them all clacking away. 100% bad news.
Disregard for proper scientific method. But he was bold enough to try something we haven't. Our procedural writing machines are promising, but we could understand the effects of Cauldron Lake's threshold much better by observing live artists in action. Thanks to Hartman, we even have a list of prospects. Next step is to send Dr. Darling a request to bring some into the lake house for analysis.
Say no to extra firepower. Huh. back where I started. Spatial recurrence usually observes the law of three.
Stood back from the canvas. He didn't recognize the piece. Did he paint this? His mind was foggy, unfocused. He knew the marble.
Thank you.
Loop 3 should be the last one.
I keep coming back to this page. The author's clearly awake. It's like he's warning us. But about what? I mean, what does it mean? This page scared Jules away from work on Wake's writing. A coward can't stand risk. Science is risk. For me, this is proof that we are going in the right direction. I just need Rudolph Lane's paintings to lead to more pages so that hopefully one day we can understand.
Locked. Maybe there's another way in. Shifting phenomena. Open without power. You again. What happened to you? Did the people here do this to you?
Mammon's clogging his head!
Alan Wake's writing is being studied here. Do you know anything about him?
Names don't matter. A thousand more to come.
They say clear communication is the key to any relationship. You and I have some work to do there. You said marmots before. Do they do this? Where are they now?
Misery! Hate.
Tell me where they are! Fixated on the marmots. What did they do? A threshold is the connection between a foreign reality and our own. Now, they all have their own rules, strange as they are, but the further down I went, the more chaotic this one got. Clearly, this was the Cauldron Lake threshold, but something was wrong. Well, more wrong than usual.
Sublevel 2.
Level-wide lockdown in effect. Please remain calm. Level-wide lockdown in effect. Please remain calm.
Open while the floor is on lockdown. I wonder what happened here.
Jules Marmont looked at the painting. He didn't understand it. Saw only random whirls of color. Drug and Lane made him more compliant, but his work had turned abstract. Jules needed more art his team could parse, could test. Trial and error. These abstract explosions of color complicated the data. His grip tightened around the letter opener in his hand. The piece of art he needed was hidden inside Lane. If Jules could simply cut the painter open and pull the painting out of him, he would. The overhead lights flickered. Jules would make Lane cooperate. No more drugs. Less carrot, more stick. Jules had to go faster. He wouldn't lose to Diana. Nothing else mattered.
I can't paint anymore. I know you want me to paint, but I can't. I'm empty.
Rudolph, no. You love to paint. And you are such a talent. This is just the classic artist slump.
No. No, I hate it. It's just taking from me now. When can I leave? You said you'd let me leave.
Ah, Rudolph, but you volunteered to come, remember? We are helping you, like Dr. Hartmann did. Perhaps you need to see our doctor? I can arrange that.
No. No, that's... I am feeling better. Much better. I will paint.
Ah, this is wonderful to hear, Rudolph. I knew you would come back to your old self.
Access card. Sorry, but I need this. How many paintings did they have this guy make?
Lockdown lifted. You are now safe to resume working.
Estevez, come in. Facility. Sublevel 1. You copy?
No. Turn back. Area is extremely hostile. On floor 1. I'll need help.
I had a thought today. A possible avenue for further research. When we think of art successfully affecting reality, we always think of Alan Wake and his writing. This could be due to recency bias or simply the amount of recorded evidence skewing our opinion. But also, I wonder if writing's very nature is an advantage. Text can describe events in such explicit detail. The story gives the shadow a blueprint, a map of what to make real. But not all art is like this. Music, sculpture, dance, cuisine, in our case, a painting. When the source material is open to interpretation, how will the shadow choose to interpret it? I think Diana will find the question very interesting. Most likely, she already has an answer. That's why I love her.
My team was on sublevel one. I knew they were in danger. The Marmonts turned innocent people into tools using the FBC's authority. They thought they were untouchable out here, hidden away in the woods. No. Actions have consequences. And I'm the consequences.
Sublevel one.
You fucking bastard! Jules Marmont killed my team. He was taken by the Shadow. I should get that gun while I'm up here. This should get me down to sublevel five. And this should get me past any other problems.
There was a crack in the lake house. The Marmonts had let the lake in, but the water could not flow. I became trapped, stagnant, went bad. The truth was controlled here. The art was not art, just content for the experiment. The contrived overlap rebounded on itself, compressing, compounding, reflecting, and refracting. An urban legend and a murder in constant imbalance, cause and effect hopelessly entangled. Arranged wrong, the dream logic flawed. The feedback loop doubled and redoubled, out of control. The pressure kept building, looking for a release.
The shadow had changed Jules Marmont into a hostile, paranatural entity. That made everything simpler. No arrest, no paperwork. I could put him down like the monster he was.
Sublevel 2.
Lane was found dead in his cell this morning. pizza. An unfortunate setback. But when a door is closed, a window is opened. I believe that's the saying. Lane may be gone, but he left us with a goodbye present. A final piece of art. This piece is different. It's raw emotion, pure truth. He put everything he had into this one. Literally. Every reading we take is off the charts. This is what we have been waiting for. It is the key. I will achieve what no one has before me. Not darling, that arrogant shit. Not my selfish, harpy of a wife.
So, we have a painter and a painting that can talk. Clearly connected. But Lane was dead before any of this even happened.
I never needed any of it. Fools will finally see me for the genius I am.
There was a crack in the lake house.
Water dripped from the ceiling as Diana stared at the folders stacked on her workstation. Each one was a branch of research. Drip. Some were thin, some thick. They represented years of her life, her work, dissecting the act of creation and examining the bloody pieces, bringing in live subjects had been her idea. Drip. Bureau leadership denied their request. But after HQ went into lockdown, she took advantage of the chaos and got her artists. Jules had whined about the optics. Diana ignored him. Now in her office below the waterline of Cauldron Lake, she considered how to proceed. Jules was convinced the page they had found would come true. It promised disaster. A situation out of control. Impossible. Diana was always in control. Drip. Drip. She needed answers. She needed to quantify, to define, to control.
Team has found new pages written by Wake. He must have gotten Rudolph Lane painting again. His bullshit pedestrian methodology cannot produce results before mine. I have to go faster, no matter the cost. We're still behind our projections. The more the machines can produce, the closer we can calibrate them to Wake's style. A proper calibration takes a lot of raw material, and production is slow. No, we're changing directions. The hypothesis remains unchanged. Imitating Wake's writing style will allow us to generate art capable of linking with a threshold. Our live subject should match Wake's style much faster. Can be calibrated just like a machine. You simply have to push the right buttons.
Vermonts were holding a painter here. Rudolph Lane. Does that ring a bell?
The shape of a man!
I think you are, or were, Rudolph Lane.
Himself! A self-portrait! Make them see!
Look, I might be able to help you. But I need information, cooperation.
No push! Just himself!
Lane was dying, both murderer and victim. Red hues ran down his hands. Was it scarlet or cadmium? Too vivid to be maroon. Names don't matter, he decided. Color was pure, inspiring. For the first time in years, he wanted to paint a self-portrait to say goodbye. No. To make them remember. To make them see what they did. He slapped his hands against the wall to steady himself. He began from there. No brush. Just himself. The strokes were crude. Violent. The pain, misery, and hate he'd endured there. The fire in his eyes and hands and bones all spread into the shape of a man. It was quick. Natural. Like a heart attack. He slumped down to the floor, smiling at the anger he left smeared across the wall.
Nice office.
Anna sat in her office. A weak desk light kept the darkness around her at night. The silence of the archive suited her. She scowled at a series of graphs when the room turned red. Alarms blared. Breach detected. Then the walls of the archives rumbled. A tremor in the bones of the facility. One by one, the red lights went dark as a wave of nothing poured in from all sides. Diana stood, but there was nowhere to run. The sheer depth of the darkness terrified her. She realized they had done this. Her and Jules. Their ambition. Their hatred. Her desk lamp flickered. In the brief moment before it all went dark, she thought of Jules' smile.
I'm sorry!
This fucking maze.
Rich Jules. Oh, and he's reportedly misplaced the manuscript pages I need for my work. Suddenly, the exact pages that I need to reference have just vanished. He is actively impeding critical bureau research.
This doesn't look like
I mean,
style.
If he can do that,
different artist.
Then what is stopping me from going down to that lab and I don't know, just inverting the amplifiers or misaligning the receivers or both? It's the same thing in principle. He booked the lab.
September 13th, 2023, notes regarding the concept of the tortured artist. A romanticized image of the sensitive artistic temperament, yes. But there may be truth in the cliche. It's no secret Rudolph Lane has been unhappy here for years. But the aggregate data shows his art's viability score trending upward over time. If Jules hadn't neglected to hold regular psychological exams, then we could have quantified the subject's emotional state, creating a sort of distress rating to compare against the art score. I'll make this a sub-goal of my study of Edward Booker. Once we set the variables and establish a control reading of his art and mental state, then we can begin inducing negative emotion. Limited food and water, perhaps. An increasingly tight living space. This is how Jules lost his subject, though. You need to be careful not to leave any sharp objects in Booker's cell.
The lake house was underwater. The Marmont's ambitions had finally been realized. Jules had dangled the painting like a lure and hooked an ocean. Their machines couldn't hold it. A fault in the system. The water rushed in, filled it until it was ready to burst. All their successes and failures had led them here. The work had made them into monsters. But the lake house was still theirs. It always would be. They could feel an outsider trespassing in their labs. I know you're here, they called out to the dark. They hunted floor by floor. They wouldn't let the intruder stop their progress. This was their home, their beloved tomb beneath the waves. The lake house was underwater. Yeah.
Sublevel 5.
Opened the door into Cauldron Lake's threshold. It was forced. It was unstable. Shutting the experiment down was the only option.
Entity, that's all there is to it.
happen again.
The putrid wake he could never wash away!
The Marmonts are dead. I don't know if that's any sort of consolation, but... it's done.
The pain, it was all over him!
Look, I'm sorry. I know you didn't make a choice here. It's not fair, but I have to shut this threshold down before it fractures.
Agent Estevez stood in the forest just outside of Bright Falls. She watched her team detain Alan Wake and Ilmo Costa, stuffing them into black SUVs. She realized this was the moment Wake had been writing in the vision she had seen. The story was coming true. She pushed the thought out of her head. It had been a good tip, a way to find Wake. Nothing more.
Alan Wake!
After the threshold event collapsed, I was back at Cauldron Lake. But for a moment, I was somewhere else. I saw Alan Wake there. He was writing about me finding him in Bright Falls, in the woods. It was a good tip. I called the surviving members of my team, and I told them to meet me there. You know, these cases, they never get less ambiguous or easier. This one, this was tough. Because protocol says entities like the Taken are monsters, threats. But the Marmonts were monsters way before the Shadow got to them. So at the end of the day, what's the difference?
We wrote so many things, wrote them for you and me. We're here standing on a precipice. We are ready to take a leap, but that only comes after. For this was the end scene. This was the end of an era. This was the sum of my body of work. When I'll be long gone, you can hold this together, and you can take it or leave it, everything that comes after, and we'll always have this, all these moments that led us here, all this joy and these heartaches, they're woven into our very to look back and see you've come so far. Yes.
Deep breaths, deep breaths. Clock stopped, and another shoe was dropped. What a mess, what a mess. Deep breaths. Six deep breaths, forget all the rest. Sharp pain, sharp pain. There's something in the way. What next? Sharp pain. Deep breaths. Six deep breaths, forget all the rest. Go, go, I gotta let go, go of everything that I've ever known. Deep breaths. Slow, gotta take it slow, 'cause that's the fastest way that I know. Deep breaths. Six deep breaths till the pain subsides. Six deep breaths till I'm fine, fine. Six deep breaths, swallow all my pride. And just like that, I've arrived. Something isn't right. It might be best to fill the test. Deep breaths. Six deep breaths, forget all the rest. Roadblock feels like my heart already stopped. Too much stress, bones to reset. Deep breaths. Six deep breaths, forget all the rest. Go, I gotta let go, go of everything that I've ever known. Deep breaths. Slow, gotta take it slow, 'cause that's the fastest way that I know. Deep breaths. Six deep breaths till the fear subsides. Six deep breaths till I'm mine, I'm mine. Six deep breaths, you can wait outside. And just like that, just like that.